Hey, what's going on, everybody? And welcome back to Controversy, a gaming podcast. So today you might notice a little something different. Honestly, today we're doing like a quickie. And that means exactly what you think it means. But basically today I just wanted to hop on here and go over a couple of updates and some news stuff and just some stuff about Controversy. So Salsa, his birthday was yesterday, so he, for all intents and purposes, he couldn't record last night, and we were gonna record this morning, but you know how it goes. Sometimes you get a little bit of one of those nights where you don't want to wake up in the morning. So today we're just going to go over a couple just quick things, and some of these things will actually go more into more detail in a later episode. But this is just to make sure that we continue to put out content for you all. So I guess welcome to the first Isaac's Quickie on Controversy. So to get us started, just a couple quick things. First of all, thank you everybody for continuing to support us, and of course, thanks to the people who continue to follow us on Twitter, like our content, and everything else. We greatly appreciate it, and you know, we hope to continue to grow the channel. I know I'd mentioned in a prior video that I'd like to try and get as close to 100 subscribers before the end of the year, and I think we can do it, but we're really excited for that. But looks like right now the couple things that we wanted to talk about. First and foremost, a fan favorite, a wonderful game that I know that Salsa really enjoys. He's always enjoyed it. Halo. So the Halo Master Chief Collection is getting optimizations for Xbox X Series, Series X, and Series S. So that being said, that's pretty big news. I feel like I know that there are some additional Halo games that are, you know, planned to come out. I believe it was Halo Infinite is the next big one. But the Master Chief Collection getting optimization is kind of a big deal, just because the Master Chief Collection, I mean, Halo, Microsoft has been doing giveaways, or actually it may have been another company, but they've been doing giveaways for the Halo Master Chief Collection as well as the Xbox Series X. And everything else. So Halo's been under the spotlight for some time. I know that they've had some rocky past with releasing content and video games. So the Halo Master Chief Collection was actually, I feel like, a pretty big deal when it came out. And that being said, getting a optimization on the next gen is also a pretty big deal. So hopefully that'll look good, and you know, we'll get to play that as well. In addition to that, a couple other things that were going on here. EA is being sued in Canada over loot boxes. Nothing surprising there. EA has a long list of getting sued for various things. Pardon me. And I'm not going to edit that out just because that'll be a lot of work for me to edit out one yawn, so sue me. Yeah, EA is getting sued. Not that I'm surprised. EA has had what I would call a rocky past when it comes to, you know, loot boxes and everything else. I know, like, a lot of places are not exactly cool with the whole loot box process. A lot of people consider it to be gambling, and that's sort of a bad thing. So EA has gotten sued a few times, but yeah, so that happened in Canada, of course. In addition to that, this is somewhat gaming news, but I thought it was interesting to put out there. I guess I believe she's a senator, maybe, or a member of the House of Representatives. I cannot remember. But AOC, Alexandria, the first last name, but it's Alexandria Cortez, I believe it is. But AOC, she did a live stream of Among Us, which I don't know, it's one of those things where, like, I mean, you know, that's cool, man. You know, you do you, but I don't know. Seems sort of like they're trying to, oh, hey, we're just like you guys, to a little too much. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I'm sure Salsa would have some opinions about her playing it, because I don't think he cares for her too much, politically speaking. But yeah, she just started playing Among Us on Twitch, I guess, and it was one of the biggest Twitch streams of all time, which is cool. But I don't understand if there's like a purpose behind it or not. I've not really watched the stream or any highlights, so I don't know if there was like a reason that they were doing the stream, if there was like some thing or project, or maybe they're just doing it to do it. I don't know. I don't know what the motivation was behind that. Who knows? But irregardless, that did happen. Also, something kind of big, and this is my last thing before I wanted to talk about something else here. But also for folks who do have PlayStation Plus and who do like PlayStation Plus, bro, they've been freaking discounting pay PlayStation Plus like nobody's business. I remember it was like a few dollars off, but now it's like $34 a year right now, with and there's like a promo code that's going around for it. I don't know, man. It's honestly, that's wild to me. I remember when I first got a PlayStation, I got PlayStation Plus for a few months, just because I had bought Modern Warfare as one of the games for the console, and that was obviously a little bit after I got it. But I, of course, sorry about that again. It's early, so I'm a little tired here. But I remember I got PlayStation Plus for a few months, and I don't know, I didn't really see the purpose of having PlayStation Plus. It didn't really benefit me that much. I don't really play a lot online a whole lot, and I don't know, the free games that you get with PlayStation Plus aren't as big of a lure as I thought they would be. Because quite frankly, like with Xbox, the free games that you get with their not the Games Pass, it's just the game free games with gold, I think it is. The free games you get with them are typically better. I remember they put out like, you know, Lego Star Wars, you know, Saga Edition or whatever. And they put out some other stuff too that was pretty cool. I remember at one point they had like, it was one of the Resident Evil games. Pardon me again. But they had one of the Resident Evil games free on there. I think it was one of the either Resident Evil 1 remake or maybe 0. They had Gears of War for a little while. I mean, they also have some stinkers. I know they put out some absolutely random junk. But other than that, I mean, it's the I don't really personally see the utilization in having you know, the PlayStation Plus, like, unless you play online a lot. And that actually kind of leads into my other topic, is that I hate that a lot of these companies are joining the bandwagon, even Nintendo does it, of, you know, there's a paywall for you to play online or to use certain online features. You know, I you know, for instance, the Nintendo Switch, you have to pay to use online utilization and stuff like that. You know, my fiance, or my wife, I should say, because I am married, she has we have a Nintendo Switch, and she likes to play Animal Crossing, of course. And you know, with her Animal Crossing playing, you know, she does have the, you know, whatever Nintendo has. Honestly, don't even remember what it's called, but then she has whatever the online Nintendo thing is that the Nintendo Switch has, and it's not expensive by any means. Matter of fact, and actually, but it just seems pointless, you know, because you don't really get too much with that. I think they have a couple of free games that you get, or like one. I think one of them was like a, it's like a mod, like a some sort of mod, or not a mod, I apologize. It's like an emulator for the NES and the SNES. But yeah, I mean, that is what it is. It's not entirely worth it, like I said, but I mean, I guess you get, at least it's something. You know, some of these other companies, you know, PlayStation and Xbox, they do give you free stuff when you buy the Gold or the PlayStation Plus, but I don't know, man, unless you're really playing online, there's really no reason to have it. I know Salsa really enjoys the Games Pass, and as we've talked about, they, you know, they've added a lot of good, great stuff to Games Pass, including a lot of EA titles, because I know EA has their own type of Games Pass. I think it's called EA All Access or something like that. So, you know, they've merged that with Games Pass, so, you know, you can get all of the Microsoft titles as well as all of the EA titles, so that's pretty cool. But other than that, I don't see any of these subscription services being really worth it, in my opinion. But that's, again, just personal conjecture. Another thing I wanted to talk about that a lot of folks may remember from previously is that I'm a huge fan of Horizon Zero Dawn, and the Horizon Zero Dawn, obviously, they released their primary game a few years ago, and then they had an expansion on the game called Frozen Wilds. And, you know, I've gone through and I've played pretty much all of Horizon Zero Dawn as well as Frozen Wilds. I'm actually right now working on completing the game 100%, but I think I'm like at 75%. I've put, I think, 30, 40 hours in the game. I don't know. Probably less than that. I'm probably over-exaggerating that. But anyways, they are coming out with another Horizon game, which I'm kind of excited about. If I'm not mistaken, it's like Forbidden West, I think it is. So there's a lot of conjecture about the game, you know, what the content's going to be. There are new monsters in the game, or I don't want to say monsters, new machines in the game. So that'll be cool to see. But, you know, Horizon Zero Dawn has been one of my favorite games lately. I feel like anytime I play a game, it's Horizon Zero Dawn, because I'm always finding new stuff to do it there. And, you know, and I'm really excited for the second game, too, because for a while there really wasn't much in regards to a sequel. And then they kind of came out of the woodworks with the announcement of Forbidden West. So, you know, that'll be pretty cool. I think that given the content of Horizon Zero Dawn, you can almost string out that series as long as you want it to be strung out, because, I mean, it's a really basic game style. I mean, you shoot monsters, pardon me, and you kind of just go from there. And so I feel like you can really do whatever you want with that series. You know, and I think the overarching theme of this new one is that you're going into a forbidden part of the world. You know, if you've ever played Horizon Zero Dawn, you are confined to a singular map. obviously the map is different in layer, because there are some underground areas to the game, and there are even some, in the sky parts where you're like in these really tall buildings and whatnot. So, but you are confined to a singular landmass, and you really can't see outside of this like hypothetical landmass. I feel like the theme that they're going to be going with Forbidden West is you are going to be embarking on a different part of the world that is outside of this landmass, and it's called the Forbidden West. My theory, and obviously I could, and this is again conjecture, but there may already be information out there, like, indicating what the game is about. But I've not really been looking at anything or any spoilers. I've been just kind of doing it at my own pace and watching trailers. So I really don't know much about the game at all. But my personal conjecture will be that we'll be venturing into a different landmass of some sort. And this landmass will be the Forbidden West. So the Forbidden West will most likely be some part of the world that we've yet to see or explore. And that'll be interesting, because you certainly, you get this feel of the world, And then it's interesting. It really is. And I think that'll be really cool for us to see, because like I said, I really enjoyed Zero Dawn, the first game there, and you know, even the expansion was, I feel like, worthwhile. I feel like, you know, the content that you get and the amount of play time you get with that is, it is actually pretty nice. So definitely I've not been let down by Horizon Zero Dawn yet. So I guess we'll just have to see how this new game goes, because I have a feeling it'll be great. I have a feeling that it'll be challenging, just as the previous games have been. So I don't know. I guess we'll see. But I will say this. I can't remember the release date, but one thing that they're doing that I do like with Horizon Zero Dawn is that they are still releasing a PlayStation 4 title. So that'll be interesting to see that the optimization on the PlayStation 5, because Horizon Zero Dawn is an exclusive for PlayStation. I know they released a PC version, but specifically I don't think that they'll ever release a Xbox version of the game. So that being said, if you have a PlayStation or a PC, you can play the first game, and I would imagine that the second game will follow suit. Yeah, the Horizon Zero Dawn Forbidden West will have a PlayStation 4 title, in addition to a PlayStation 5, and the graphics on the PlayStation 4 are great, so it'll be really interesting to see, you know, how much better it is on the 5. I feel that way about a lot of the games that are getting optimization for the 5, as well as optimization for the Xbox Series X or Series S. So I feel like we have a lot of potential, you know, honestly, a lot of games that are going to get remade and that are going to really revolutionize the graphics industry and everything else. So, you know, it's kind of exciting, especially when you get a new console. This is the same excitement I had back when the 360 phased out and they phased in the Xbox One, was that, you know, the Xbox One was supposed to be better graphics and this, that, and the other. So it is certainly it really is. I'm excited. It's really, really excited. But anyway, so last thing I wanted to talk about is that there is another player in the streets, if you will. So there's obviously everybody knows Amazon, and I feel like I kind of anticipated this. I've actually talked to Salsa about this, and Salsa kind of agreed. We always anticipated that at some point Amazon would try their hand at a gaming system. But so there is something called the Amazon Luna, and they are actually inviting folks to an early access trial. Basically, the Amazon Luna is a cloud streaming gaming, a cloud gaming service. You have to pay a monthly subscription, and according to this, it's a $6 a month monthly subscription, as well as an invite. At this point, they're still like in early access, so I'm sure that they're still like testing stuff. But you also have to have the invite to purchase the $50 Luna controller. And so they have cloud gaming. Let's see. Basically, the people who signed up, who bought the controller, they're getting a 7-day free trial, after which they have to pay a beta price of $6 a month, which what that means for us is that more than likely the $6 a month is just to get their foot in the door. It'll most likely increase if it's successful. And then the controller has an early access discount of $50, but it will eventually increase to $70. Which, I mean, considering that it's a cloud streaming service and you don't have to buy a console, you just have to be able to, because it's compatible with PC, Mac, and Fire TV, and it's going to be the first streaming service available on the iOS for iPhone and iPad. There's no Android support yet, but its compatibility with iOS is going to definitely give it a leg up, in my opinion. We've even talked about this before on the podcast that, there is the Microsoft or the Xbox streaming service that they have that's not available on iOS. It is available on Amazon, however. But just as a kind of a example here, on the Luma, Luna, There are some games that are on here. There's a Tetris game. There's Metro Exodus. There's something called The Surge. Nothing really that I recognize. I'm assuming these may be some lesser known titles, or this may even be some Amazon IPs for all I know. It's about 50 games, and they're able to stream at 1080p at 60fps, which is pretty impressive. So I really don't know much of these, many of these games, unfortunately, but apparently some of these are pretty good. I know that Metro Exodus is pretty good, but yeah, so basically there's only about 50 games at this point, but it's actually pretty cool. Now I will say that at this juncture, I don't know if you have to buy the individual games or if the subscription itself will cover every game that's on the streaming service, but I mean, realistically, $70 to buy the controller to be compatible to play, and then, you know, however much the actual cost of the subscription will be, because right now it's only at $6, but that is a beta price, so that means that it will go up. And like we said, if you, I guess they're sending out early invites for early access to purchase the controller, and the early access cost of the controller is $50, but like we said, it'd go up to $60, so, or I'm sorry, $70, so I guess we can assume that marginally the price of subscription will probably be closer to the $20 range post beta. So, I mean, $70 controller, probably a $20 a month subscription. I don't know if that would be worth it, in my opinion. And the reason I said $20 is obviously it could be potentially be less than that shit. I mean, it could be more than that. But the reason I said I threw $20 out there is that's not much different than some other forms of streaming services and everything else. So, I mean, not entirely indifferent to other forms of that. I will say that with the controller, I'm assuming it's going to be a Bluetooth type setting. And as we mentioned, it is available on PC, Mac, and Fire TV, and is going to be available on iOS for iPhone and iPad. So the controller, I'm assuming, is going to be a Bluetooth type controller, no physical plug-in, which also means that it'll most likely to be a, let's see, trying to look here. It doesn't give specific details on the controller itself, but my guess is going to be it's going to be battery powered. I don't suppose that they'll give you a rechargeable controller right off the bat, but I'm assuming that this is obviously the beta, so you'll get the controller, and then the controller will most likely improve just as it does with every console. You know, you get your base controller, and then you can make modifications such as a battery pack and whatnot. But a couple things that they have said about the streaming service is that the access of the library is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So, you know, there's more games getting put on there. There is unlimited hours on all the, so there's not like a limitation on how long you can play. Games stream 1080p to 60fps and it claims that 4K is coming soon. And then there's also the ability to play on two devices at a time. So that's interesting. You can play on two devices at the same time? I would assume at the same time. So I guess that's cool. I mean, if you can afford two controllers, you can technically have two people playing on the same account at one time, it looks like. So but then actually that opens up another question, is that, you know, a lot of the games on the iPhone and iPad, you can connect a Bluetooth controller to them. For instance, there's the Call of Duty game mobile. You can actually connect your controller to that and play like you normally would, like on a console. So I wonder if this will be compatible with other Bluetooth controllers. I have a feeling that it probably won't be. I feel like that if you're not going to buy the $70 Luna controller, then I feel like they don't want you playing. I could be wrong. I hope I'm wrong, but I have a feeling that that'll probably be a point of contention with the streaming service. But it's also interesting that it'll be available on iOS. So I'm not sure. I feel like me and Salsa talked about previously that the Xbox was available on Android, but not Apple. So I wonder if the Amazon Luna was in the process of being made, and maybe they already had a deal with Apple that, you know, hey, we're going to have a cloud streaming service, so we'll put our streaming service on your device if you don't put the Xbox cloud streaming service on your device. So I wonder if that was kind of the reason they did that, and the reason why they also don't have support on Android at this point, because according to this, there's no Android support yet. So I mean, that could mean that there will be Android support, or that could mean that there will never be Android support, and that is being done on purpose. So I guess we'll see. This is kind of cool. I like Amazon, generally speaking. I think that Jeff Bezos is not exactly my kind of guy. You know, he's a billionaire who doesn't like to pay his employees a livable wage everywhere. So I guess that's not great. I mean, it could be worse. I mean, you know, but I mean, Amazon is at least trying to get into the market. I've thought for a long time that Amazon will eventually create a game system of some sort. But I guess that given that Amazon is, you know, they have a streaming service and they have all this electronic service stuff, it doesn't surprise me that they would go with a console-less streaming service. So, you know, and also there's not a whole lot of games on there right now. So, I mean, personally, if I was invited to this beta, I wouldn't do it just because, you know, I don't think that I could comfortably purchase a $50, you know, controller specifically for this, and then also pay $6 a month for a streaming service for games that I'm not gonna play. You know, I already have an Xbox and I have a PlayStation, and I intend on buying the Xbox X Series when it's available for me. I'm going to buy the S Series. I'm gonna get the discless version because fuck it, why not? Yeah, I don't see myself purchasing this just because I have the other two formats, and I do eventually want to get a gaming computer as well. I've been working on that for a couple of reasons, but you know, I'm of the belief that if you're going to do something, do it right. And I don't know. I have a feeling that this whole Amazon Luna may not pan out to be the best that it could be. But, yeah, I guess we'll see. But I don't want to keep this going for too long. I think 30 minutes is sufficient of me rambling. But otherwise, I mean, I like the Amazon Luna. It'll be interesting to... It's an interesting concept, I should say. I like the concept. But I guess we'll see. It's really just going to depend on, to me, what it's going to depend on is, you know, how expansive is the library going to be? You know, it looks like it has Metro Exodus. So it has, you know, some IPs that, you know, or some other companies' IPs and everything else that look like they're, you know, has potential. But I think the big thing for me is going to be, you know, how expansive is the library going to be? Are you going to have new release games, you know, and are other, you know, is PlayStation going to let you, you know, let you put exclusives on there? Are we going to see Halo on the Amazon Luna? And I mean, it's not really a gaming console. It's just a streaming service. So I don't know if that's a true competitor to, you know, PlayStation, because PlayStation doesn't have a streaming service. Xbox does. So I have a feeling that any Xbox IPs or even Bethesda, as we've talked about, you know, Bethesda got bought out by Xbox and Microsoft, so I have a doubt that you'll see any of those IPs on there either, but I don't know. I guess we'll see. But for right now, I'm going to stop it here. You guys will hear from Salsa next week. Like we said, you know, yesterday was his birthday. Outside of that, for right now, guys, stay safe, stay happy, stay healthy, and keep on growing. See ya.